Welcome to game number two, guys. Sorry, there's a such a long jump between game number one and game number two, but if you're watching the VODs, I guess it's just like, poof, magic, we're already in game number two and you didn't miss a thing. Spotting here at the top right corner of the map, competing in the Ender J Cup monthly finals. Oh, it's the finals of the finals. Give it up for Teffel. Polish red Zerg player, and you find him on Twitter at Dignitas Teffel. His opponent in the lower left, playing for My Insanity. From Switzerland, he is the Korean champion known as Stardust. And of course, you find him on Twitter at StardustSC2. Small shout out, Nod. I don't know if he's still in chat hanging around, but Zervas was he is a teammate of Stardust and he's a cool dude. I saw him in chat earlier today. Just a little bit of a recognition. What's up? So currently leading the series 1-0 in this best of five as displayed down here. Teffel took a very aggressive game number one, to say the least. We'll see if Stardust is ready for it or not. Again, Stardust plays a very unique style. Like, there's two players. Okay, so there's Protoss who have their typical all-ins, right? Like, you say Protoss all-in, everyone kind of immediately pictures sentries in some sort of composition. Players like Stardust, players like Arthur, they do all-ins, but they add their own little flair to it, whether it's by hitting at earlier timings, less zealots, more stalkers, heavier sentries, I mean, what have you. They do it differently is the thing. The one sad reality is, though, Teffel is a very aggressive player who also can perform all-ins and just happened to manage to out-bully Stardust last time. If that attack he sent had come, like, even 15 seconds later, the second Colossus had been out, the first Colossus had extended Thermal Lance. I mean, any number of things could have been different and completely changed the way that game ended up. But for now, Teffel's just probably coming into Yanzi ready to be aggressive once again. He's very... very aggressive player. He goes toe-to-toe with Koreans on a regular basis. Not just Stardust, for example, but many others that he's competed with in many European Cups. Let's see how he, if he can actually do this. I thought, you know, someone on Twitter even tweeted me saying, like, Teffel 3-0 easy peasy. I don't know that I agree with that, but if he takes game number two on Yanzi of all maps, I would not be shocked if that ended up being the case. But no gases for Teffel just yet, so still playing a little bit gasless for the time being. You, of course, can get away with this. You want that third hatchery usually before you start taking gas. And, of course, there's always that quote-unquote heated debate. Do you take this base? Or do you take this base? This base sucks. But sometimes it's more convenient to take. For a Zerg player, it's kind of preference, I feel, more than anything else. This one seems to be the most common one taken as a Zerg player, but... you know, Forge Expand coming out once again. Getwee's already finished up here, but Teffel has seen most of this, if not all of this, yes. So he's seen everything coming down here, and Joan's being transferred. Joan will be taken to the third, I imagine, in a moment's time. Don't know what he's waiting for. He's got a lot of money. Money, money, money. Enough for another hatchery, at least, but he's just going to keep up with Queens and Injects for now. Going to get those drones running rampant. Of course, you do pick up your drone count pretty quickly. Chrono Boost is nice, but it's got nothing on an extra hatchery. It looks like Stardust predicting that this would be the more common base. He's got a probe over here waiting. No real point in pylon blocking this. He still might go for it just to be a bit of a nuisance, like, you know, build and cancel it, but reality is you typically expect links to be out and available by now, so you don't invest too much into a block. Okay, gonna put the pylon down. If he lets this complete, I'm a little bit curious on that. Teffel, of course, has no lings though, but typically you assume a Zerg player will. Even if it's just two to scout with, bring them over and start killing and chipping away at the pylon, but... looks like he's gonna be a nuisance, and Teffel's just gonna say, screw it, I'm not dealing with it. Just gonna take my third down here, not waste any time. Alright, well, the extra gateway's coming down. I was kind of waiting to see if that was going to happen. We got the Course Immortals going to be pumped out a little bit sooner this game than last time. And sentries are already ready and available to go. You know, it's a little bit interesting things, too. When you back up and consider, for Wings of Liberty... Whoa, back up, hang on. Warp Prism. I was going to start talking about how Sentry Immortal pushes were always the go-to. You'd see them first and foremost above anything else. But we actually have the Warp Prism coming out. I'm a little bit curious what he's planning to do with this. So, on one hand, you could... if we had extra sentries out, I would assume he was going to just force field off the ramp and try to knock a base down, but... with the really low sentry count, this may just simply be for pylon usage. Oh, he's going to pick up the sentry and go. He'll probably pick up a zealot, too, or warp some in. I don't know. This is a weird push. One sentry, not that strong. It really isn't. Did Teffel see that pylon coming down? He does. It's in full vision. So he puts a couple of spine cars down to make sure this isn't going to be a problem. Stardust, unfortunately, envisioned that Overlord. Not going to get too much done. And that Warp Prism... That Warp Prism was really curious to me. Because, okay, so... The point I'm kind of rambling at here, guys... You typically have... Four sentries in this, right? You unload at the top of the ramp. You force field off indefinitely, and you warp in like 10 or 15 zealots. What Stardust is doing right now, I think, is he's trying to fake out Teffel. He wants him to think it's going to be this giant warping attack from this pylon, that it's going to be non-stop zealot aggression, and quite frankly, it'll fall back into that. I'll talk about that more in a second. He's going to force field this off. He'll use the Immortal to pulley down the roaches, warp in some zealots up here initially, I imagine, and then use this pylon down here to attack this base while Teffel's clustered at the ramp trying to get back towards the main. That's my assumption, that's my guess. But sentries are warped in, and force fields will go down in a moment's time. He's gonna need more than just one Immortal for damage, though, that's for sure. Does take out these roaches quite handily. Meanwhile, Zealot's still alive, and looks like this pylon was revealed. So, if Teffel knocks this down, he's actually not gonna have to worry about anything other than what's currently in the main. No spine cars in the main coming down, curiously enough, though, so... A little bit dangerous. He's gotta know there's no reinforcements, and oh! Stardust is actually gonna kill the Roach Warrior, which means, A, no more roaches to be built, but more importantly than that, he cancels Galal Reconstitution. Roach Speed has been shut down effectively. Zealot and an Immortal at home will defend, and... This is what I'm talking about, guys. With Stardust, when I say he does his own like unique variations of these builds, typically, like I said, you've got four sentries and you warp in a ton of zealots, but instead of bringing the Immortal across the map, like this was fantastic. Up to six kills, still has a lot of damage behind this, and let's not forget, more force heals to just choke this ramp off all freaking day if he wants to. Of course, a big counterattack is going to go off, but two Immortals are at home. There's a hell of a lot of pylons coming down to hold on. Mothership core is a non-existent, so no overcharge to aid to this. But the Immortals and the Cannon combined have way too much damage for these Roaches to deal with. A couple of defensive warpins are all that's necessary, and even now, a second Cannon will hold the line. Three Immortals in total, he is good to go. The one downside, though, is the Stardust, while he's focusing at home, dead let up on the force fields on the ramp, so drones were pulled to the main. Roaches were pulled into the main. A couple Zealots, though, slicing and dicing with this Immortal. A really cool victory coming out of Stardust in game number two, evening up the series now 1-1. Big props to Stardust for making that work. That was really cool.